let's talk about the content marketing advantage. All right. So when it comes to, by the way, when I say content marketing, what I'm talking about is content that you create specifically with the purpose of growing your list or getting people to take action towards buying with you. So it might be an opt-in. It could be, a, you know, the call to action could be opt-in. It could be register for a webinar. It could be book in for a strategy session with me or a triage call, etc. But it's content designed to sell. I don't know if you've heard me say this, but the line between content on the one hand and marketing on the other has blurred. So, you know, in the old days, you know, you'd have the newspaper and then they put ads in. So there's, you know, the content in the newspaper, the ads, and then they created advertorial, right? They had TV and ads, and then they created infomercials, right? Which is a blur between content and marketing. In movie, you know, they had movies, you know, at the cinema, the movies and the ads, and now they have product placement. Yeah. So the line between content and marketing has blurred, and we want to make sure that we are in that sweet spot where it's really useful content that also converts incredibly well. So that's some context for us today. If we talk about the problems, I think kind of three or four key problems that happen when it comes to content marketing. First thing is this, you know, creating great content is hard. Like, you don't know what to say. You don't know how to say it. There's frictions. And we talked a little bit about that 2 weeks ago in the Authority Accelerator, right? So, but for many of us, creating content is tricky, particularly creating content that works, right? Number two, even if you do create content and put it out there, people are tuned off, you know, tuned out. They're not watching you, they're watching somebody else. They're either, you know, literally watching something else, or they're following somebody else. That either way, they're not paying attention to you and your messages. You don't have enough eyeballs on your stuff, right? So you're creating all this stuff for a tiny audience. Super frustrating. And number three, even if they enjoy it, you can't see the ROI. Like, people are reading a thing and they're clicking like. Well, likes are okay, but I'd much rather leads. You know what I mean? So it's frustrating to create stuff and have nobody do anything with it. So they're kind of disengaged and not moving. All up, that leads to kind of like you're on a treadmill. Okay, I know that I've got to, you know, keep my blog updated, or I've got to write a newsletter once a week or once a month or once a fortnight, whatever you do. But if you're not getting a return from it, then it feels like it's a wasted opportunity. Mel, I know we chatted in our strategy session, our game plan, about the content you do and how do we increase its stickiness and engagement, right? So it feels like a waste of time. In fact, the very first coach I ever worked with was a guy called David. And he used to write an email newsletter and send it once every, I think it was maybe every month or every 2 weeks, maybe once a month. And he's so frustrated that people just didn't, like, he'd have call to actions, like different action, you know, a bunch of different articles, different call to actions every edition. And people just wouldn't do anything with it. They literally would not reply. And he got so frustrated that after about 7 or 8 months of this, he literally, I was the proofreader, so I pulled it out, but he was going to send an email saying, hey, if you're reading this, hit reply and I'll give you $50. Just let me know that there's somebody out there, right? Frustrating. There's nothing worse than creating content and having, you know, going to all the effort of creating content and having nothing come back your way. So that, if you like, is the bad news. Let's talk about the good news. If you get this right, if you get marketing content dialed in, here's what happens. Well, instead of like it being hard to know what to write about, you just get spoon-fed great ideas, right? Good ideas come to you, like laid out on a platter, and you're just going to do what it says. Number two, instead of people kind of tuned out and disengaged, you create addicts, people who can't wait to read your stuff, can't wait to watch your videos, can't wait to read your articles, can't wait to listen to your podcast. I got asked 3 times last week, hey, so when's your next episode of the podcast with James coming out? I'm like, well, we just recorded it. It should be live in a day or two, and it came out, I think, yesterday. Right? So here's the deal. We want to create content that has people hooked on you, on your value, and on your material, right? We want to create people who are addicted. Not only are they going to be addicted to kind of consume it, but they're going to want more, and they're going to take action, book in for events with you, register for programs with you, sign up for strategy sessions with you and coaching with you, buy tickets to your events with you. By the way, Grant Herbert, congrats on having your JV partner put on your sales workshop for you. I think it's fantastic. Well done. So we want people to want more and to take action. When you do this, then you create momentum. I remember for me, there's been three big leaps that have taken our business up if you think about kind of money and freedom, on the money side, three big things that kind of that made a huge difference. And at the time were like the quantum leap. And so the first one was webinars, you know, back in maybe 2004. No, that's not true. Sorry. 2009. 2009, first webinar, huge leap. Instantly, I could like talk to people from around the world and have them say yes, bam, income jumped, number of clients jumped, fantastic. That was the first one. The third one, so I'm skipping one. The third one was 2.5 years ago when I ran my first $1 million coach intensive and sold from an event. Big, right? But the middle one, the second leap that I had, this kind of has accelerated everything else we do, but authority marketing. You know, when I started the coachmarketingmachine.com blog and started my video, and, you know, we aim for weekly. Sometimes we don't hit it. Sometimes, we might go a few weeks, and other times we might do two in a week. But when we got good at authority marketing, at content marketing, fame jumped and I guess with it a degree of fortune. Does that make sense? So that's why I reckon this marketing content accelerator is so valuable, you know, this advantage. So that's why I reckon it's useful. More important than, I guess, than why I think it's useful is why do you think this is helpful for you? So why do you want to master marketing content?